We've all wished at one time or another that we had more time, whether it was a vacation or just to get work done. Well, tonight we found a man who can start and stop time. Jason Davis went on the road to Erskine, Minnesota.
When we go on the road, there's a place I want to see.
You get the clock and it doesn't work. You couldn't wait to dig in and repair them.
63-year-old Tom Ledding's fascination with clocks began many years ago when his father, Roger, former chief of the Minnesota Highway Patrol, gave him an old clock that did not tick.
It's a hobby gone wild. That's what it is. It's a hobby gone wild.
He's not kidding. Every room in his lakeside home near Erskine, Minnesota, is crowded with clocks of every shape, size, type, and origin. Tom Ledding would like to make a living repairing and selling old clocks, but the prices he charges barely allows him to break even.
I figure I'm wealthy with clocks.
He says he rarely, if ever, charges more than $150, even for a complete rebuild.
But if you took it to the cities or, you know, clock shops down there, they probably would run you $350 or more.
But most of his repair work is simple. The clocks are just neglected.
A lot of them I've just cleaned them, oiled them, adjusted them, done.
Over the years, Tom has collected more than 400 timepieces. They are all special in one way or another, from cheap Chinese alarm clocks celebrating Chairman Mao to intimidating grandfather clocks with melodious chimes. Some clocks have just an interesting history, like the one found in an old abandoned one-room schoolhouse.
Take it. I don't want it. There it is. So that's kind of weird.
Genuine schoolhouse clock from the town.
Right out north of Erskine here.
And an unusual calendar clock that always gets it right.
This one does leap year and everything. Like, I mean, I couldn't believe it. That mechanism on the bottom is like
amazing.
Yep.
It truly is a labor of love. A simple story of a man happy in his work.
Completing something and, you know, and getting it done and making it work and making it done.
We asked Tom Ledding how many hours a day he spends working on his clocks, and he said he didn't know. He doesn't wear a watch or keep track of time. Jason Davis, 5 Eyewitness News on the road near Erskine, Minnesota.
And Tom Ledding only works out of his house in the winter months. During the summer, he has a shop in downtown Erskine. And Jason Davis will be back with more on-the-road stories at 11 tonight, right after this newscast. Well,